हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस डिस्कस द क्वेश्चन फॉर प्रैक्टिस ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 1 व्हिच हैज बीन गिवन ऑन पेज नंबर 18. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट. योर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय चेंज ऑफ फिजिकल स्टेट एक्सप्लेन विद एग्जांपल्स. मींस व्हाट हियर यू हैव टू गिव द डेफिनेशन ऑफ फिजिकल स्टेट ऑफ विद टू एग्जांपल्स. सो What do you mean by physical change? The physical change means you will write the heading physical change. After that, you will write conversion of a substance from one physical state to another physical state is called change of physical state. For example, one, conversion of ice into water. Example 2, conversion of water into water vapor. These are the two examples. After that, question number 2, explain the terms. Here you have to give the definition of all the terms. So here A is boiling point and B is freezing point. Both has been given at page number 12. Let us see. Here, the definition of boiling point, you will write the heading boiling point, and after that you will define this. The temperature at which a liquid boils and changes into vapor gas at one atmospheric pressure is called its boiling point. For example, the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius, right? So here many examples are there, you can write if you want to write. But here you have to write only the definition. Clear? According to the question. Here, freezing point. The temperature at which a liquid freezes to become a solid at one atmospheric pressure is called freezing point. Example, freezing point of water is 0 degrees Celsius. Right? So, these are the definition. Let us see question number 3. Explain the following terms with example. Right? With examples. So here, three questions are there. Three parts are there. Evaporation, condensation, and sublimation. And evaporation is given at page number 19. So let us check it first. Here, the process. The definition of evaporation, the process in which a liquid in open vessel changes into vapor at any temperature below its boiling point is called vaporization. For example, vaporization in water. Our part B is at page number 16, so let us go. Here you will write the definition heading condensation, and you will write here conversion of vapor into liquid is called condensation. Thus, vaporization and condensation are reverse to each other. There is no need to write this line. You will write only this. Conversion of vapor into liquid is called condensation. You can write this thing. Okay. This is about your B part. Now next part is C, which is at whose definition is at page number 10. Let us go. Here the definition of sublimation has been given at page number 16 also. So we will discuss here. You will write the definition sublimation, and after that heading sublimation, and after that you will write this definition. The process in which a solid on heating directly changes into vapor without passing through the liquid state, and on cooling the vapors directly change into solid state is called sublimation. Here it means you will write definition from here to here, right? This is the third portion. Here our next question is, what do you mean by latent heat? Explain with example. So the definition of latent heat has been given at page number 15. So let us see. Here you will write the heading latent heat, and this is the definition. The heat energy which is supplied to change the physical state of substance is called latent heat, right? This is the definition of latent heat. During this supply, the temperature of the substance does not increase, right? So, and examples of latent heat are latent heat of fusion and latent heat of vaporization, right? And you can write the amount of heat energy that is required to change 1 kilogram of a solid to liquid at atmospheric pressure at its melting point is known as latent heat of fusion. And you can write that latent heat of vaporization, the amount of heat energy that is required to change 1 kilogram of liquid into its vapors at atmospheric pressure at its boiling point is known as latent heat of vaporization, right? This is the definition of latent heat of vaporization. During conversion from one physical state to another physical state, the energy which is supplied to the substances for conversion, for increasing the internal energy of the molecules, the one state of matter is converted into another state. During this, the temperature of the substance does not change. That is why the name latent heat has been given. So this is the definition of latent heat and their examples. Here last question is, does the temperature of water at 100 degree Celsius and steam is same? It means you have to give the reason with suitable you will have to give the reason also. So your answer will be yes, because water is in the form of liquid, clear, it has some special kinetic energy and internal energy, whole energy. But when we supply more energy to it, the supplied energy increases the internal energy of the molecules, and therefore there is no increase in the kinetic due to which the temperature does not increases, and the conversion of water takes place into the water vapor, due to which the temperature of water and steam at 100 degree centigrade will be same. Clear? At 100 degree the temperature of water and steam will be same. Hello students, now let us discuss question for practice at page number 22. Let us discuss the question answer. Here we take the first question. Why does a desert cooler cool better on a hot and dry day? Its answer has been given at page number 20. Here On a hot and dry day, temperature is high and air is less humid. These two factors, high temperature and less humidity, increase the rate of evaporation of water present in the cooler. More heat energy is taken from the surroundings and desert cooler cools better. This is the reason. So, how does the water, next question is, how does the water kept in earthen pot, matka or pitcher, becomes cool during the summer? Its answer is also given on page number 20. Here, pitcher or earthen pot has large number of very small pores through which water seeps out. This water takes heat equal to latent heat of evaporation from the pitcher, and the water present in it evaporates. Since heat is taken from the water, it gets cooled. You will write from here to here. You can use earthen pot or pitcher. So this is the answer of second question. Now we take the next question. Why does our palm feel cool when we put some petrol, acetone or perfume on it? Its answer has been given on page number 20. Let us see here at the page number 20. If we put a little of petrol at the spirit, you can use perfume or acetone on the palm and wave it, palm feels cool. It is because petrol, perfume, acetone, etc. take heat from the palm for evaporation, causing the palm to feel cool. Petrol, spirit, acetone, etc. change from liquid to vapor state and they take heat equivalent to latent heat of vaporization from the palm, right? But you can, your answer is complete here, so you can write from here to here. Clear? Fourth question is, why it is easy to sip hot tea or milk from saucer rather than a cup? It means what? The answer will be, in the saucer, the surface area of for the evaporation is greater, and in the cup it is less. Therefore, greater evaporation takes place from the surface of the saucer, and in cup the less evaporation takes place, due to which the milk or tea becomes cooler in saucer than that of cup. Therefore, it is easy to sip hot tea or milk from the saucer rather than a cup. Right? This will be your answer. Now, let us see. Next question. What type of clothes should you wear in summer? Its answer has been given on page number 20. Let us see. Here, during summer, we sweat more. During evaporation, the particles at the surface of the liquid take energy from the surroundings and change into the vapor. The heat energy equal to the latent heat of evaporation is taken from the body. The evaporation of the sweat makes the body cool. So, cotton is a good absorber of water. Cotton clothes absorb the sweat and expose it to the atmosphere for easy evaporation. Therefore, in the summer, we should wear cotton clothes. Right? This is your answer. Your sixth question is, ice has cooling effect whereas steam causes severe burns. Explain. It means ice has less energy than that of normal heat energy of our body. Therefore, when ice comes in contact with our body, it takes energy from our body. That is why ice creates the cooling effect. When the energy is released or taken from our body, we feel cool. But in the case of steam has greater energy than that of our body. That is why it has very much greater energy than that of our body. Therefore, when the water vapor comes in contact with our body, it gives heat energy to our body. That is why it gives intensive heat energy to our body, due to which it causes severe burns. Right? This is the answer of your sixth question. Now all the questions for practice have been completed. This is all about the QFP of chapter number 1.